Subscribe to Naija's Craziest. Press the bell icon and never miss another video update.
My sons.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Bia, in Apuala. See, on this, we are not a Zemo. You are not a Aboki from Kano. Don't you people leave character? We are doing something else. You people are spoiling it with a...
Yes, Papa.
Okay, yes, Papa.
Uh-huh.
Daddy, we want you to tell us a story.
A story? We want a story?
Yes.
I'm going to tell you a story about a prophet.
Please tell us.
This is a story about Pastor Odumeje. They say he called himself the lion.
Papa, we have plenty lion. Is he the real lion that we always see in the zoo, or the one that is always in the bush, or is he lion tribe of the Judah, or what kind of lion?
It's a were lion. Do you understand
that lion son? That have Yahweh, that is
the lion that thinks is a wrestler. So meanwhile, the lion that most people know is the normal lion. The program venue was full. The crowd was plentiful and impressive. For you to know that the lion has many fans, home and abroad.
So remember, the lion used to use hand fan.
No. A standing fan.
Hi.
At the program, he was singing, dancing, and preaching in his usual way, you know, the WWE style way. As he was singing, come and see the way Nigerians were spraying him money. Everywhere still. Money. The whole place, the whole ground was filled like a new carpet on the floor. Money.
Sorry, everywhere still. There's no fufu to balance the...
No, there was no fufu.
Okay.
Only still.
It's not just stew that is red.
So money was everywhere on the floor. People were wondering, where did all these people get this money from? At some point, some of the people lay down on the ground.
They live their life.
No, they lie down on the ground for him to be walking on them like Jesus Christ.
They will not wound in their back.
Even if they wound, I don't know. But he was walking on people. You know the way Jesus walked on water. The funny part was that some of them even thought it was a good idea to be recording this stupidity. As they were recording and recording different kind of videos, some people watching it, they were like surprised. Even Jesus Christ watching from heaven was wondering, is this what I died for?
Papa, that Jesus cannot die for that kind of person. It's a waste of death.
Jesus died for all of us.
He died for everybody.
For your...
Not in the Bible. Daddy, I told you, this boy, don't used to go to church, Sunday school, don't go.
I know, because every time I give him money to go, he usually branches the other place. And I suspect him. Anyway, even the devil was flabbergasted and surprised. As in, he thought he was bad. And there's no record of the devil climbing on people. So the devil was surprised. No record climbing on people physically, but he climbed on people metaphorically.
Okay, Papa, that metal, he was climbing on there and there was metal on top of.
Also, all the money I used to send you children to school, this is coming out.
Sorry, you did not know anything. You say metal is a three people in person, animal, place, or things.
You remember?
Metaphorically.
Yes. Papa, the story.
School fees wasted. Okay. Even Angel Michael in heaven was watching the whole bra for him and he couldn't take it anymore. He went to ask God, is it time to blow the trumpet?
No. Papa, why would they blow trumpet when we have not married and you know?
No.
Do.
What is that? I don't want to do anything.
You ask this mother.
In all of this, the Indonesia government was watching. Indonesia government was watching what was happening in the church. They were watching keenly. The Nigerian people did not know. Pastor Odumeje did not know. And they started asking questions, calculating how many Nigerians in Jakarta had valid travel documents, stay and papers. And by the time they were done checking, they found out that those without papers were plenty in Amwala. Will you wake up? I'm telling story, you're sleeping.
Sorry, that is how he carried last.
Yes, because he sleeps in school.
The lie is second to the last.
What a useless somebody. That's how the government got angry. How can all these people not have valid papers? And they are spraying such amount of money. Where do they have work?
Sorry, it's true. They did not give us any money out of the money. It's not good.
It's a bad story. Are you in the story?
You are not in my story now.
Why would they give us money?
You be up to to.
I'm talking.
Let me continue my story, okay, Joshua.
Papa, continue. Let us hear.
Before we knew what was happening, they sent police to go and arrest and deport many Nigerians as possible.
So, is it the Nigerian police? Because I know those ones there.
No, if it's Nigerian police, they would collect bribe and let the Nigerians go. No, so it's Indonesia police.
What is Indonesia police doing in India now? Is it not India?
Nah, Pia. So, when I said Indonesia, Jakarta, is Jakarta in India?
Indonesia is the capital of India now.
Hi!
No, it's a state.
Yeah, let me just finish my story.
Biko. No problem. The police came.
So, police started deporting Nigerians back to Nigeria. That's how everywhere scatter. Those without valid papers started hiding. Yes. Some people even tried to hide their friend inside ceiling. Some hide them inside bag.
Hey, Papa, they do not have sense, though.
Why?
Because those ones that have paper, they would have do photocopy and give to those ones that don't have paper.
Problem. Yes, so, they will not be able to report them. Yes, they just say, where is your photocopy passport paper? Just show them.
Just will not kill us.
Yeah. You just show them. Papa, showing them that one alone, that alone.
Chanugi, what is wrong with you people? Is your head come empty?
It's his own. It's command, it's kakam.
So, okay, why don't you go and make photocopy of your international passport?
Me, I did not have, we did not give me anyone.
Let me finish my story. The government then gave order that any landlord that failed to report any illegal immigrant living in their property without valid paper, they will have their property seized and confiscated.
That is, Papa, that man, Odumodu, did not only cause problem for the Nigerians there, it also cause problem for owners of house.
You know it.
Station
you
of
see,
Nigerian
you have brain. Now you are using
I
your brain.
I tell you I have brain, Papa.
That is how they started rounding up all our Nigerians for deportation. Now many of them are wondering, who asked Odumeje to come for program?
You see.
Say nobody would have spread money and they would have still been evading government. They are some to be deported who attended the program and even offered themselves to be work on. After all the pain from being climbed on, nothing to show. Some of them were even hoping that when they come back, the lion will pray them back to abroad. But I'm sure they have not seen the lion.
Okay, what to do that thing that passport has did for that useless, that man.
You will travel without passport. No visa. You don't.
It will shock them. It does not work. It will shock them.
Nnamdi was one of those caught by the police.
Nnamdi Amadioha.
Or Nnamdi Kanu.
No, not Nnamdi Kanu. Because don't bring
Bia. Is Nnamdi Azikiwe?
No, it's Nnamdi Amadioha Mumu.
Okay, let's continue. He also attended the program and spread his 3 months' profit on the pastor. Money that he would have used to buy tickets and sneak into Malaysia.
That is a good advice. So do not go and do yahoo.
When Odumeji fans and supporters club heard the news, they started protesting against the actions of the Indonesian government. Odumeji came back to Nigeria as he wanted to bring down South Africa. He went into spiritual welfare to bring down Indonesia as a country.
It was like a missile that went, he dodged the. I could not go to the place he's supposed to go. Now went to.
So, my children, that is the end of my story. So, what is the moral lesson from my story? You first.
Papa, I get plenty things.
Tell me.
Plenty things. I first of all gain that it is stupidity for anybody to become a wrestler and want to preach at the same time. Okay. It does not make sense. And it's, the two is, if you don't have passport, don't be going up and down and be spraying money like you don't have sense. Of course, those people in that story, they don't have sense. And lesson number three, Papa, I'm sitting.
Don't worry. When you're done thinking. Hey, Joshua, what did you learn from my story?
What you learn from the story you say? Papa Felix, start from the beginning to the end, I will tell you. Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, Papa!
Papa, don't kill him now.
I will kill him today.